Hello everyone, how are we doing today? I am back actually with my review of the Cyanics Portable Swing Speaker System with protective casing for the iPod Touch first generation and second generation. Yes, you heard me correct, this casing does work perfectly with both first and second generation. So I'm pretty much just throwing everything out of the package. But what I'm going to actually be showing you today, I'm sure most of you have already seen the unboxing video of this. This is going to be very similar, just my actual thoughts about it. I've had this casing for about 2 or 3 days now. I have been using it surprisingly more than I expected due to its great durability and great protectiveness for your iPod. But anyway, as you see on the back of here, what it actually is going to be able to do for you is protect your iPod with a plastic casing, but also it has speakers that flip out in the back, or the swing speaker system, that will flip out into the back and produce great, loud, crisp quality sound that will work with audio or with movies actually, which is definitely a great feature. And the great thing about movies is you can flip this open and prop it up in widescreen view. So if you're sitting at your desk or at a table at lunch or something during a lunch break, you'll actually be able to watch a movie or just a TV show, and you'll actually still be able to use the swing speakers perfectly. So if you have more people viewing the same screen, you don't want to actually have to share earbuds. You can actually just have 4 or 5 people watching from the same screen while it's still producing the same sound quality that you would if you were to have it flipped up in the front view. So anyway, that's going to be the backing, and that's pretty much just a quick little run through of what the speaker system can actually do. Now I'll show you what's actually included and how it works. It's definitely a great product. So you have this little charging cable that's actually included. The charging cable is only going to be used to actually charge the battery itself. If you have your iPod put in, it will not charge your iPod because your 30-pin connector is not used here at all. But anyway, so you can plug that into the backing of the speaker system somewhere right over here. That's where you're actually going to be plugging it into the top of the speaker system. So you'll still be able to actually use them while being charged. It's definitely a great feature about them. Most products you are able to do that, but some you're not. And aside from that, this shows you where the charge slot is. Charging slot is right up there. So let's actually get my iPod, and I will show you how awesome the speaker system and casing is. I thought this casing was going to be ratty, just a little plastic casing that would just be able to hold my iPod in while it's using the speakers. It's a great casing, actually. I would probably use this, even when I'm not using the speaker system. I just wear this around, because what it is, this is the first casing that I've ever seen that has a swing latch door. So you actually do put it in right there. I don't know how to say that. It snatches right there, snaps right there. I guess that'd be the right one. So you just pop that little door tab up, and here you go. You have this little hinge over here, and you can actually just leave it right there. It sits right there for you. Here's my audio pin, which will stick into the bottom of my iPod Touch, first gen or second generation, which is definitely a great feature. Close this nice and tight, and it is not going anywhere. It's nice and snug in there. Once it's in there, you have to actually flip it open from this side. Definitely a great feature about it, so your iPod will be nice and safe in there. All of your ports are still exposed. You have your sleep-wake at the top, your volume rocker switch, which is definitely still very easy to get to. Your entire front touchscreen is still naked and completely exposed to use. You also have your home button switch down at the bottom, very easy to get to. And 30-pin connector, as you see, I'll zoom in a little bit for you. 30-pin connector is still very easy to get to because your 30-pin connector, you can still charge your iPod while watching or listening to music or videos or whatever. Down here, you see that your iPod's audio jack is actually taken up, but right here, that gets transferred onto the bottom of the actual speakers that will flip out themselves. So if you want to be using this casing but not have to actually use the speaker function, you can just put your audio headphones into there, and you'll be able to listen to them individually by yourself. Or while you have the speaker system, you flip it out just like that, and there you go. Now you have your loud, awesome speakers built into the back. If you want to actually see this function from the back, it has a nice Cyanics logo actually put there, and it flips open. It feels very similar, like I said earlier in the unboxing, to the Sidekick, the T-Mobile Sidekick. It feels very similar to that, the way that it actually flips open. It's definitely a great hinge on how it actually works, and The coolest thing about this is over here. This is going to be a little bit harder to see. We'll actually try and just zoom in. This little tab right here, as you guys see, you flip that down, pull the speakers out, lock it, and there you go. And that's how you get into widescreen view. So if I want to be watching a movie, I just prop it up just like that. If you want to see from a different view, prop it up, and it props up on its own, so you can actually be able to watch a video or a movie while using the speaker. So if you have multiple people viewing the same screen from the same time, you don't want to have to use a lot of audio jack splitters, you don't have to share earbuds, or use the internal speakers, because honestly, those really can't be that loud. These built-in swing speakers are tremendously loud for your iPod. We have Bob Marley playing right now for some reason. But anyway, let's go on to a new song. There we go. It's Tricky by Run DMC. Why not? One more thing just to add, you control the volume of the speakers through your iPod or iPod, or the iPod first gen or second gen. There's no speaker volume switch over here. All you have is the on, auto, and off, and then the headphone jack at the bottom and the charging port. Same thing. Okay, so as you see, the speakers work great with audio like music. Let's go into video and we'll actually just watch a movie. Why not just do Hot Rod, since that's the legal one that's out. Okay, so we have Hot Rod on my iPod.
So I thought it'd be fun if we all went around and said our name and a little something about ourselves. I'll start. My name is Rod,
and I like to party. Funny movie if you haven't seen it. That's Hot Rod. But anyway, guys, just pull that little tab back, and my speakers are now back into the full screen or the front view so we can actually swing them up and use them just like that. So as you see, the blue LED does indicate that the iPod speakers are on. Turn it to auto. Turn it to off. And there we go. Back to where it came from. So that's going to be the review of the Cyanics Portable Swing Speaker System for the iPod Touch 1st Gen and 2nd Gen. Out of all the products I review, this is not going to be the most amazing. I'm not going to say this is the best one, because that would get really redundant. But I do recommend getting this. This is an awesome product. This blew my mind. It completely exceeded the standards that I thought it would be. I thought it was going to be a crummy casing with some pretty weak speakers. It looks like a gimmicky product, but they made a gimmicky product, but they made it great. They did a fantastic job building this product. The swinging actual hinge for the speakers, how you can go into full screen right here, or you can go into the widescreen view, how it works with everything. You still have all your ports easily accessible. They did a fantastic job with this product. I give them huge kudos to that. Great job. If you want to go check out the product at the site, www.cyanics.com. The link is over here in the sidebar. I do recommend to go get this. This is a great product. I have not found a flaw yet, and I've been using it for a few days. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this review. I will talk to you later. Have a fantastic day.